Okay, we're back here at the Reading Fall Street Fair, the main stage of RCTV's coverage of the Reading Fall Street Fair. We've been having a lot of fun. We've talked to a lot of people today.
Definitely.
My name is Kevin Vent. This is Laura Crook. And we have with us today Seth Moulton, who is a candidate for Congress in the 6th District. And you have a primary coming up this week, and then maybe the general election coming up in November. So thank you for taking a few minutes and talking with us today.
Well, thank you for having me. It's great to be here.
Absolutely.
So have you enjoyed the street fair thus far?
Oh, the street fair has been amazing. Yeah, there's an incredible number of folks out here. Great booths, great people. And pretty good weather, too.
Yes, we are very grateful that the rain rained out yesterday and then, you know, gave us beautiful weather today. So as you approach the primary and then hopefully the general election in the fall, we know that candidates or that political races can have a lot of challenges, but
sure.
What is your favorite part of running for office?
It's the people that I meet,
mm-hmm.
and every single day, and the people I meet in the district, they're eager for some change. You
mm-hmm.
know, Washington is broken, and fundamentally, we can't fix Washington
mm-hmm.
if we keep sending the same people back again and again. And to get out there and meet folks who are excited about creating some change, to bring jobs back to the district, to ensure educational opportunity for all, to finally take care of our veterans, and to make sure that women get paid the same as men. Those are things that people care about, and they want new leadership to get it done.
Absolutely.
So as you look at kind of the needs of this district, and you also have to have an eye on national concern
right.
as well when you're in Congress, what do you see as kind of the most pressing issue?
You know, the number one issue is jobs. Despite the recovery in the economy, if you look at unemployment in the district, it's gone over 107% since Congressman Tierney took office.
Mm-hmm.
107% rise in unemployment. So that's not good. The 6th district has higher unemployment than the rest of the state. We can do better. We need economic development. I think we need a congressman who understands economic development. And, you know, if you want a good example of what can be done, look at what Congressman Paul Tsongas did for the city of Lowell.
Mm-hmm.
Turn that city around. That's the kind of leadership we need here in the 6th.
So do you have any specific thoughts on that issue?
Yes, actually, we have an economic development plan for Lynn that we're in the process of releasing.
Okay.
And I think that, it was in Gloucester last night. We need to get the fishermen back to fishing.
Mm.
And so there's a lot of things that need to be done. Some of them are very specific to certain towns. Others are more broad, education and job training,
mm-hmm.
connecting businesses with the new Essex Aggie Technical
yep.
School.
Yeah.
That will not only help the students who become workers, it'll help bring businesses to the district. So if you do that right, public-private partnerships, you can get a lot done.
Excellent.
So have you had a chance to check out much of the street fair?
Yes, I've been all the way down and all the way back.
Nice.
So met hundreds of voters, everybody's excited about Tuesday. Everybody's
yeah.
watching the race.
Yeah.
You know, we just had a new poll come out that showed me up by two. So
that's
the last
awesome.
Poll said basically dead heat, but
mm-hmm.
But down by three, now up by two. So everything's going in the right direction. Momentum is definitely on our side. And the other thing I think it's important for Democrats to
mm-hmm.
know is that the poll showed that I'm 8 points over Richard Tesei in the general election, whereas Congressman Tierney is 8 points behind Richard Tesei.
Mm-hmm.
So if Democrats want to elect someone who can hold the seat and ensure that this stays Democratic, then they need to choose me in the primary on Tuesday. And
absolutely.
I'd be honored to have their support.
Well, that sounds like a ringing endorsement there. I know you've gotten a couple of big endorsements. I know the Boston Globe has endorsed you for the seat. So we wish you all the best of luck in the primary.
Yeah, no, thank you very much.
Tuesday.
I've been honored by the endorsements. Actually, we've received 7 newspaper endorsements.
Okay.
Congressman Tierney hasn't received any yet. But it shows that I think there's a real desire for change out there. And I would be honored to help bring that to the 6th District of Massachusetts.
Well, thank you very much. Thank you for coming to the Reading Street Fair today. And thank you for joining us here on RCTV and giving the voters a chance to get to know you a little bit. And we just, again, wish you luck in the primary and hopefully again in November.
Thanks so much.
All right.
Take care.
Thank you very much.
Thank
we
you.
Are headed out now to Ryan Pinnett.